Good evening, students. So today we will be doing a few questions from the model papers given by Pote Sharma garu. These are relevant to environment, to history, to geography, to economics, which are in news recently. Yeah, so we should be like, you know, getting an info, getting an idea about all these topics, though they have happened like, you know, little in 2021 in August or September. Definitely, again, before you go for the exam, this will be relevant also. You should have the knowledge of it. Now, first question is about how sir gives it is, we will be, how sir gives it is, all the points which are there, like India and EU. EU means European Union. So related to these two, why was it in news and what are the important points? So all those important points together, he'll give the questions in such a way that all those important points regarding that current affairs will be given to you, right? So now here, what is this European Union? Anybody who can tell? What is this European Union?
Ma'am, I think England and some other countries together are called as European Union.
Yeah. So the group of countries in Europe which have come together, because each country, it's like, no, it's like our country having different states. Each country is like small in size. When people are moving from one country to another country for their business or for job purposes, they have different currencies, different rules and regulations. So it was very difficult for the trade and commerce to be carrying on. So that's why they have formed into a union, right? So this, what is it that they should be having it in common? What are the things that they should be working together? So for that, United Nations Security Council had come up with a meeting, and in that meeting, our Honorable Prime Minister also has given a speech over there. So in that, he started off saying that India and EU are natural partners. Most of the countries in the Europe, they came, they did business over here. There, like East India Company, Portuguese, Dutch, all these people came to India in search of good trade prospects. They came here, they ruled small provinces in our country, and finally, East India Company took over the whole of the country, and we came out of it getting our independence, right? So our partnership is very, very important for the global peace and stability. So he wanted the values to be universal. So some kind of set of rules for trade and commerce. So this will not happen in one meeting, right? Post the coronavirus pandemic, now it is time that all the countries come together. You must be knowing that India had provided vaccines to all over the world, many countries around the world, right? So he said that it is time that we all work together post-pandemic so that everybody will sustain, every country's economy will sustain properly, right? So there are so many values which are similar to one another, like democracy, multilateralism, and all these concepts which are there, which are very much relevant. And there is so much of scope for all the countries to stay together and work together for the prosperity of the human mankind, right? Now, the second question is about Kosasta Lyre River. Where is this? This is in Tamil Nadu. What happened to this particular dam? What happened? What was the name of the dam which was constructed across this river? Many dams across yeah, Tamil Nadu, you will find that they were constructed during the British regime or when East India Company was there, then they were constructed. Why are these dams constructed? Tell me. What is the
news? Because to get new fresh water.
Fresh water, okay. To store water, yes. Because all the water will go into the sea or the ocean, right? So Chennai is very close to the, it's on the, it has the coast with the Bay of Bengal. But always Chennai has huge water problem, drinking water problem it has. So this particular river, the dam has been constructed so that the water is stored and the water problems or drinking water problems of Chennai is somehow prevented. Now, what happened? Why is it in news? It is, where is it? It is down, while the river is flowing down from 15 kilometers down of Pundi Reservoir. Yes, this is the prime storage point. And what is the length of it? Length of that dam, 190.80 meters long. Well, in the previous class, we have learned another dam. All these dams are very old, right? So environmentalists will be worried about, yeah, are these dams safe? Because if there are, when there is heavy flow of water, what happens? There will be slight cracks in the dam, and suddenly if it breaks, yeah, all the low-lying areas, all the areas which are there, the districts or the places which are there around that dam will all get submerged in water. So in the previous class also, we have learned about these dams, one near Mysore also, yeah, where these old dams, environmentalists will be trying to warn people, trying to say that, yeah, please take care of these dams. Otherwise, there will be, they can at any point of time, due to earthquakes or any other reason, there can be a damage to the dam, and all the low-lying downstream, all those places which are there can suddenly get submerged in the water. You must have remembered, I think so, it is in the year 2010. Karnool was totally submerged. Yeah, there is Tungabhadra which is flowing, right? So Tungabhadra River up on the dam has, the gates have been opened and suddenly, Karnool got flooded. Flooded and all the people who were, in the low-lying areas, suddenly water came into their houses and they were suddenly homeless. So like that, to avoid any kind of such situations, people will be, environmentalists will be warning the governments and also the NGOs will be working for it. If any repairs need to be done for old dams, they need to start working on it. Next, the third question is about super spreaders. We are talking, this is in the context of COVID-19. COVID-19, what is it? Why, who are called as super spreaders? The vegetable vendors, are the most vulnerable groups of, why? Because they go to, see, this is not the days of like Big Basket or getting your groceries or your vegetables, not online. These people are going to place, selling their vegetables. So they get in contact. There is more exposure for them in contact with several people. So when they are coming in contact with so many people, what happens? There are chances that they will get COVID. They are getting infected by coronavirus. So what is it that people should do? What is it that government should do? Yeah, trying to give them alternate ways in which they can survive. Yes, there were so many videos across when coronavirus was at its peak, correct? Saying that please take care of your the security guards, the watchmen, the sweepers who are there. Please inquire, how are they living? Can we do something? Provide little clothing, or the dhobis who are there, our house, the maids who are there. Please, make a call. Try to find out. We stop it, taking help from any of these helpers who are there. Plumber, electrician, then maid, security guard, our watchmen, dhobi, the person who does iron and all these. All these suddenly came to standstill, right? So it is time that on humanitarian grounds, we should be able to try to talk to them and find out how they are. If they need clothes, or if they need food, if they need a little bit of money, we should be definitely helping them out so that they come out of this situation with being human. I think so, it's very, very essential, right? So, but to take care of them has become so, so difficult, and to provide them help also has become very, very difficult during the COVID times. Now, this is another problem. One is those who are all with the basic help for the people, like vegetable vendor and other things which I have told. There is another problem called as reverse migration. You must be remembering that with the first wave of COVID, what happened? People traveled across the country to their hometowns. They carried children, they carried luggage on their heads and walked for hundreds of kilometers. So now, when the situation is okay, why did they all come to the cities? Why did they all of them come to the cities?
Because there will be more work in cities. For example, construction work.
Construction work, especially. Construction work. There are huge buildings. You may need a watchman, a security, plumber, electrician. These kind of jobs. Mason. You need, so construction is, it is at its peak, construction. So people from northeastern states, Maharashtra, Telangana, all these people, to Hyderabad, to all the metropolitan cities for the constructions. When the metro is going on, metro rail construction is going on also, all these people are very much needed. We should always think, right? Who constructed our house, the beautiful houses that we live in. At one point of time, all the laborers, we should be always thanking them for constructing the house. And they went off. They went off on another task, correct? So what is this reverse migration? That all these people started moving, going back to their native places, right? So we already spoke about one nation, one ration card also. At that time only, this scheme has started up saying that wherever they are, for their livelihood, for their jobs, if they have gone to another state also, government should be able to give them the ration. Ration means the essential commodities, food items which they will give, chawal, that is rice or dal or wheat, oil packets, sugar, the basic things which they will give, right? So all that should, these people should be able to get it wherever they are. So social security network should be there, and all these basic amenities should be definitely be taken care of. This one, this particular sovereign portfolio guarantee, this with the banking economics sir will teach you. Now postal ballots. What is this postal ballot facility? During 2020 July, it was a peak of, I should say the COVID lockdown pandemic was at its peak. At that time, assembly elections were conducted in Bihar. So for the safety and for the facility of the people who are above 65 years of age, they have started with this postal ballot system. What is a ballot system? Charan, do you know what is ballot system?
Ma'am, I think it is about elections.
Elections, yeah. So the person, the member whom I want to elect, I will be marking that name and putting it in the ballot box so that no other person should know. It should be kept a secret so that whom I have voted, nobody knows. It will be only I will know about it, right? So for the sake of the electors who are above the age of 65, this postal ballot facility was made available, right? Next, Sattarghat Bridge. Why was this bridge in news? On June 16th, Mr. Kumar, he has inaugurated the bridge, which is 1.4 kilometers long, right? And then suddenly what happened? Within 29 days of the inauguration, there were floods, in the Gandak River, and it got washed away. Whenever we are constructing huge buildings or dams, huge constructions, we need to be very, very careful. No compromise on the quality should be there. And a proper architecture, plan should be there, and the building material which is used also should be properly put up. If you remember, when this metro rail was going on, metro rail project, or I think so, it is a flyover in Panjagutta, Hyderabad. If you remember that flyover which was there has the base of where the pillars are there, that base which is below that was little, because of the rains, it became little soft, and the whole of the bridge came down. So such cases we have to be very, very careful, because there will be people traveling on that road, correct? So whether it is dams, whether it is railways or metro trains or flyovers, we need to be very, very careful with that. So that's why Sattarghat Bridge was in news, and it got washed away. Now, what is this? In the first question also, we spoke about multilateral system. What should be done? You're not able to listen, Charan. Yeah.
Okay. Ma'am, your voice is breaking, ma'am.
Okay. Right. Sometimes when the network is bad, it happens. Okay. So now, United Nations started reforming the its own system. So there, Prime Minister Honorable Modi, when he spoke, he said that there should be more representation. Why there should be more representation? When we are talking about the world, when we are talking about the good or the betterment of the countries in the world, when we want peace and prosperity in all the countries, what should be there? Every person should be given, every small country should be given, in Europe, in Africa, there are so many countries. So every country should be given a representation. Every country's problems should be put up and should be discussed. And the countries who are doing well, the countries which are doing well, those countries, the developed countries, should be helping the underdeveloped countries. Can you name few underdeveloped countries? One or two underdeveloped countries?
Bhutan,
yes. Any other name? Charan, very poor country. Any name you know?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So any developed country, can you tell the name of a developed country?
USA.
Very good. Is India a developed country or underdeveloped country?
Underdeveloped.
It's a developing country. Yeah. So why? Because still the poverty line is poverty is there, but we are progressing. We are making lot of like we have huge human resources, people who are there. Where our workforce is too good, they are skilled. If we make them skilled labor, yeah, definitely our country would become a much bigger asset for the whole world now. So in this UN's United Nations Economic and Social Council, UNESCO, United Nations Economic and Social Council, so this particular council, what does it do? After, again, everything is related to the COVID only. After the COVID, now, what should we do? How should the countries have a kind of understanding among themselves to help each other and do it in a better way, right? Now, next, ninth question is about the Kusum. Kusum's full form is Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Mahabhyan. Urja means energy, right? So it can be a kind of solar pumps. Why we are encouraging solar pumps? Though the initial cost is more, there are no maintenance charges. There are always in the villages, what happens? There are huge power cuts. So all the time it's troubling the farmer, correct? So that's why if we can have solar pumps to all the farmers, so that these solar pumps can be given by this particular mission. The Prime Minister is trying to give it at 70% subsidy. First come, first service, and they can definitely be utilizing it. Yes, and it has good horsepower also. The speed, with the power of it is also good, and people can make use of it. Next one. This is very interesting. Lion population. As you all know, Prime Minister Modi is from Gujarat. First, initially, he was the chief minister of Gujarat. Later, he took over, he came into the national politics, and he became the prime minister. So, on June 5th, the forest of personnel have suddenly started checking out on the lion population, right? So, the lion population, they have given a report saying that it has significantly increased. That means previously it was 523. Save tiger, saving wild animals, saving as a kind of we will keep trying to make sure that this wildlife is taken care of, right? So in that, they have told that it has increased to 674. And Prime Minister Modi also has appreciated them. Excellent feat, very good. But the press people and the critics are the ones who will always question, right? Said, how is it possible that within 24 hours you can count so many thousands of squares of kilometers? How could it be, how could that be done? So that's a question mark. So they are going back in checking the authenticity of the data which is given. Now, 11th question, this is a very interesting one. Population growth in India and other countries. Which is the first largest populated country in the world? With the highest population. Which country? Hello, no one. What is the place of India when it comes to population? Hello? India is the second largest. Hello?
Ma'am.
Yeah. Suddenly it got disconnected. Voices. So China is the first when it comes to population, with the highest population, and next comes India, right? So what is it that by the end of the century, how is it going to be? We are in only 2021. By 2100, how will the population be? So it is called a census, right? When they start counting the population, they have done it in 2011, then again 2021, then 31. Every 10 years, they check it out. So with this rate of increase in the population, by 2047, India is going to reach to the population of 1.61 billion. But later, again, they're going to come down to 1.03 billion. Presently, what is the population?
1.61 billion.
Now?
130 crores, ma'am.
1.3 billion, right? So it is going to increase to 1.61, but again, it will come down in another 53 years. Up to 47, it's going to be like that. From 47, again, it will decrease by 2100. So, if at all, this, what is the reason for it to increase and then again decrease? Maybe there will be methods in which the population can be controlled. Yeah, more and more people will try to have, previously, each family used to have 3 children, 4 children, and now presently it is 2 children. Yeah, probably people will go for 1 child, right? So like this, when it is growing, by the end of it, what is it that overall the around the world, the countries, how will they be? 5 largest populated countries by that time will be, first one will be India, second is Nigeria, third is China. It's getting disconnected. Yeah. Fourth is India, Nigeria, China, US, and then comes Pakistan. So this is the forecast, of the population in the future. So let us see how it's going to be happening, right? So Nigeria is, where is it? Which continent is Nigeria? India is in Asia, correct? Pakistan is in Asia. China is in Asia, right? Where is Nigeria?
Ma'am, I think it's in US, ma'am.
It's in Africa, right? It's in Africa, so it's an African country. So we will do the remaining questions in the next class, okay? So go through this document I will share with all of you. There will be 100 questions in this particular text. You can go through them, and we can continue in the next class. So you have been given a few topics for presentation tomorrow. Get ready with that. Yeah, if there's any issue, you can let us know also. So tomorrow we will meet at 5 p.m. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Anything else?
No, ma'am.
Okay.